Our Story Productions presents the Cocklebur Morning Show, where we weed out the big stories from throughout Sweet Swine County with Bobby Ray and Sally Sue.
Oh, thank you, thank you. It's great being here. And what a show we have today for everyone. And we have a special guest today. Betty Thompson from Cooking It Up with Betty has agreed to be our guest host today. Thank you for coming.
Oh, it's my pleasure. You know, Bobby called me on the telephone not less than an hour ago and said, be here.
That's so
I have no idea what he's up to.
I wanted to say, I think I saw you on the other show, the women's show.
Yeah, I did. I did.
Oh, honey.
It was a little hot. Those ladies, not too nice. Yeah. Not too nice.
You know, this weekend, I spent reading the new book, Not So Sweet.
Oh, you have that book.
I have
it. I heard about that.
And can I tell you the dirt that's in that book?
Ooh. And is this the book?
This is it.
Wow.
Look at this. This is it. And I tell you, it's hot. It's hot.
Not so sweet.
Not so sweet.
When the claws come out.
Oh, I know. And I tell you what, we have copies for everyone in our audience.
Oh, how great. Wonderful.
Yes. Not to say that we're trying to get better ratings.
Oh, no.
But I think this is a very important book, and I think the audience would so enjoy reading it. It's fantastic.
Yes, yes, indeed. I mean, the truth comes out.
Oh, can I tell you, you have to read it.
I'm excited.
You so have to read it.
Yes, indeed.
Okay, well, now we're going to join one of our citizens who has a report from another town outside of Sweet Swine County.
Outside Sweet Swine County?
Yes.
Well, hey, let's look at that.
Wow, sister, I can't believe Mama made us move up north. This isn't a plantation, it's a farm. Whatsoever will we find to do here?
Oh, sister, really? Fiddledy-dee. I do declare. I'm going to tell you something. I have been sneaking around. Mama doesn't know. And I have found us some towns, and we're going to be fine.
Why, sister, I do declare that's exciting. Tell me more.
Well, just last night, I found a little town right here.
Le Sueur is located 50 miles south of the Twin Cities, or 25 miles north of Mankato. Located on the Minnesota River, Le Sueur has a rich history with an active historical society and several museums. The small town atmosphere provides safe, friendly neighborhoods, affordable housing, numerous recreational activities, as well as excellent schools and medical services. You'll find Le Sueur a great place to visit and an exceptional place to move your family or company.
And sister, I want to tell you about their businesses too.
Love that town. Wasn't that fantastic?
Oh, a fun place to visit. I just can't wait to get over there myself.
I know. It looked very good.
Yeah.
So I assume that Bobby Ray has given you notes about what he did.
Oh, yes. He was very insistent. Mm-hmm. He gave me umpteen notes. He said it's a very important part of the program that the audience would just be so upset.
Yes.
And I will read what Bobby Ray wants the audience to know.
Great.
So.
Wonderful.
It is now time for
Bobby Ray's Weekend Adventures.
Oh, what a weekend Bobby Ray had. And he gave me these notes, and so I'm going to read them.
Okay, great.
He traveled over to the county of Nobles, to the town of Adrian. You have to visit them. You know, you would just love it.
Okay.
Great shopping, great points of interest. Anyway, he visited the historic Slade Hotel. The Slade Hotel sits along the east side of Main Avenue in downtown Adrian. Early homesteaders, George Slade and his wife, built their 36-room electric-lit hotel for $22,000 back in 1891.
It was electric-lit?
Yes.
High
for that time.
Oh, my goodness,
yes.
Wow.
This late Victorian-style hotel consists of the oldest hotel in Minnesota under the continuous management of the same family. That many years. That's amazing. It was owned and operated by Fred and Ruth Slade until it was sold, preserved, and remodeled for small apartments and then a senior center. Some original woodwork still exists, and the Slade Hotel was named to the National Register of Historic Places on June 30th in 1975.
Well, nice.
Well, then he went on to see the historic church. When the first St. Adrian Catholic Church burned to the ground on Christmas Eve. Can you imagine
that's awful.
That?
Must have been had too many candles lit.
Could be. Could be. 1899, and it burned to the ground.
Oh.
Wow. And the fire was so hot, it melted three of the church steeple bells.
Wow.
And it was a huge ball that then fell through all the floors to the basement. Well, can you imagine three bells melting together and
break
down to the basement? Yes. The cornerstone for the new church was laid on July 4th. And the new church was completed at a cost of $22,650. Hey, that $22,000, that's a kind of a round number that they must use quite a bit back then.
Yes, they must have, yes.
And the Romanesque-style church was listed on the National Register of Historical Places in 1980, and its historic significance is listed as architect in architectural engineering. Well, this was just a couple of interesting things that he visited over in Adrian.
Oh, yes.
And, you know, if he continues to do this, you know, we're going to just see some more wonderful, wonderful places, discover these historical places when we visit
Bobby Ray's Weekend Adventures.
And you know, Betty, if he continues, our viewers will be the most well-informed viewers across the country.
Oh, you
honey,
bet.
I tell you.
Well, I'm sure they will, Sally Sue.
Yes.
But right now, let's visit another one of these wonderful towns outside Sweet Swine
That's
County.
So fun.
My name is Johnny Happeny, and I'm on the case, a big case, to find out about the downtowns in our story country. The boss wants answers to what's going on, so I walk the streets to find our downtowns that have become the greatest streets of Minnesota. The case is clear. Now I will take what I've learned to the big boss.
Montgomery is a growing progressive city, conveniently located between Burnsville and Mankato. Proud of their heritage, Montgomery has the largest Czech population in Minnesota. Each summer, they celebrate Kolaschki Days, named for a fruit-filled pastry. Excellent education, healthcare, recreational facilities, and a stable family environment of open country spaces are some of the reasons why people move to Montgomery. Montgomery welcomes you for a visit or a new place to call home. Johnny, shops, services, and entertainment. Show me some more.
Appears the talk is true. These are the towns dreams are made of. I will continue on the case, for I am Johnny Happeny. Our story, the streets of Minnesota.
Oh, I love that town. That was great. And now, I think it's time for our guest.
Ooh, well, I think that's a great idea, Sally. You know, Sally, I've always been a fan of music.
Oh.
But, you know, I've noticed on the last couple of times we've had a musician on this show.
Yeah.
Well, you seem to be quite into it. You know, a little flirty.
Well, I don't get expensive. Well, you know, I but
honest. I love live music.
I enjoy
it thoroughly. I'm a great fan of any kind of music.
Oh,
it's great, especially if you can dance to it, honey.
Well, and especially if they're good looking, like the one I saw backstage.
I know. And that brings me our guest today, Mr. Chad Elliott.
Welcome, Chad. It's great to have you with us today.
Thank you. It's great to be here.
So, Chad, can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Well, I'm an Iowa singer-songwriter and also an artisan, and I travel around the country showing my art and sharing my songs.
Oh, wonderful. Yeah.
Well, what brings you to Sweet Swine County?
Everyone's talking about it in the music business about this new commune that you've started here in your county.
Yes, the Swine Song Commune.
Yeah, that's it.
Oh.
Yeah, well, I mean, I heard that the Swine Song Commune allows musicians and artists time to get together and also to share their common interest in the arts. And well, I've decided I'm going to be a citizen of the commune.
Oh, are you going to move here?
That's exciting.
Well, no, I'm not going to move here permanently, but I... because I do a lot of traveling as a musician, but I'll be sure to stay in touch and involved through the website.
I've seen that website, Sally.
Yes. It's a great website to visit if you haven't done that. It's absolutely wonderful. So, Chad, tell us, how did you discover that you wanted to be a songwriter?
I was in college. I was studying art, and my roommate happened to have a guitar sitting in the corner, and so I picked up the guitar and I started practicing some chords, and then eventually that wasn't enough. I had to write my own words, and it just grew from there.
Amazing.
And what's your inspiration for your songs?
I think everyday life, a lot of it, and then I've also just nature always inspires me. I go out for walks a lot and hikes, and I come back with loads of ideas that I can write. And my mom was an English teacher, and so she was always encouraging me to write poetry. So it was just a way to share my poems.
That kind of goes hand in hand with
right.
it. Yes. So now I have heard about the One Horse Tour.
Yeah.
What is that?
It's a One Horse Town Tour, yeah. And it's kind of about... small town life. In Iowa, there's lots of small towns, just as there are here in Minnesota, wonderful small towns. And I thought I'd celebrate that a little bit. By next summer, I'm going to be traveling to towns under 1,000 in population and sharing my music. And so I'll be spending a month just traveling, visiting all the small towns that I might not have run across, even though I've grown up in Iowa.
What a clever idea.
You have a new album, and it's called Redemption Man. Is that correct?
Yes, that's right. I'm just releasing that now, and I'm really proud of this album. The producer is Bo Ramsey, who works with Greg Brown and Lucinda Williams and all these wonderful artists.
Wonderful.
And he plays his slide guitar on it. But I've been waiting to share these songs, and I'm finally getting it on an album, releasing it here this November.
That's exciting. That's amazing.
Oh, so exciting.
Well, you know, I've also heard about another project. I mean, you're a very busy man. but this new project is called the Den Sessions of 2010. Could you elaborate on that a little bit?
I mean, as I said, I write a lot of songs.
I guess,
and
yeah.
It's kind of like journal entries for me. Almost like every day I'll write bits of songs here and there. And so what I do is I do home recording. And so this is a way to get a lot of the home recordings that I might not have ever released. I've written over like 1,000 songs. And so I'm finally ready to just share some of these songs that I might not be able to release on a full production album.
Just great.
Amazing.
Can I hear from one of the reports of one of your citizens that have gone out to the small towns? And
you got it, Chad. We'll do that right now.
Oh, hello again. Colonel Von Breger here. I was just going over some of my adventures here in my journal. Have I ever told you about the time I was on safari in Africa? Perhaps not. Or the time I flew over uncharted waters in the Black Sea. There again, perhaps I haven't shared that with you. Well, these are some of my adventures, and I'm going to be doing other adventures now in the South, specifically southern Minnesota, visiting towns and communities, In fact, we're taking an adventure today. Why don't you join me as we go to St. James, Minnesota. St. James, the county seat of Wantowan County in southwest Minnesota, offers a wide range of opportunities for recreation and relaxation, and the kind of hometown service and hospitality that will make you want to return. With recreational opportunities offered in their lakes, parks, and the St. James Bike Trail, St. James is bully good. Visit the St. James Area Chamber of Commerce to make St. James your vacation destination. Come on over and make yourself at home. And again, bully St. James. Bully. Well, let's discover some of the fine businesses and establishments as we continue our adventure.
What a great town. Now, Chad, on top of all of your music, I understand a little person told me that you are also an artist.
That's right, yes.
What kind of type of art do you do?
Well, mainly painting. I've done a lot of pottery and sculpture and things like that, but I've gotten into acrylic painting mainly, and the paintings that I do now have become lyric paintings, where they're based off the lyrics of my songs.
How fun.
For years, I've tried to combine the two, my music and my art, and finally, I've got an avenue that I can do that.
Tell us about the song that you're going to do for us.
Right. Well, this is Barns on Fire, and it's the painting that I brought today is based off that, and it's one off the new album.
Oh, wonderful.
Oh, I'm excited.
Wonderful. I'm excited.
Yes.
We'll sit back, ladies and gentlemen, and enjoy.
When the barn's on fire, let it burn down to the ground. When the barn's on fire, let it burn down to the ground. See the smoke and the ashes, you never know what can be found. When the love's long gone, let it run away. When the love's long gone, let it run away. 'Cause you can't make a wonder and love wanna stay. So when the barn's on fire, let it burn down to the ground. When the barn's on fire, let it burn down to the ground. See the smoke and the ashes, you never know what can be found. So I go out to the country to find my peace of mind. Yeah, I go out to the country to find my peace of mind. But a cold, hungry ghost is all I could find. So when the barn's on fire, let it burn down to the ground. When the barn's on fire, let it burn down to the ground. Send the smoke and the ashes, you never know it can be found. So when the nights get cold, seep into your bones. When the nights get cold, seep into your bones. Go find a love, boy, don't live alone. So when the barn's on fire, let it burn down to the ground. When the barn's let it burn down to the ground. See the smoke and the ashes, you never know what can be found. Oh, and the barn's on fire, let it burn down to the ground. When the barn's on fire, let it burn down to the ground. See the smoke and the ashes, you never know what can be found.
Wonderful. That was just incredible. Now, could we hear another one of your songs? Could we please?
Absolutely.
Oh, fantastic. Great.
Up in Minnesota, where the stars are frozen bright, way up in Minnesota, where the stars are frozen bright, I sing myself a love song, 'cause my love can't hear me tonight. And I know I could have loved her forever and a day. I know I could have loved her forever and a day. And she would have loved me in return if I hadn't lost my way. There's something in the woods that scared the daylights out of me. There's something in the woods, mama, scared the daylights out of me. And I dropped my lantern when I ran away. Now I cannot see. And Lord, the wind, she's howling across the prairie lands. Oh Lord, the wind, she's howling across the prairie lands. And I'm still searching for that ribbon that the wind has taken out of my hand. We spoke to one another, each in our own dreams. We spoke to one another, each in our own dreams. But now I can't fall back to sleep. I'm wide awake, wondering what it means. Way up in Minnesota, way up in Minnesota, I sing myself a love song.
Oh, pretty. Oh,
that was beautiful.
Wasn't that beautiful?
Wow.
Oh, my. Oh, wow, Chad. That was just great.
It has been so great having you here. I just can't tell you how much we've enjoyed this.
Thank you so much.
Well, I think we need to see another one of those citizens reports.
Yes.
Yeah, all right.
there. I'm Lady Dot from Spottingham, England. Yes, good to see you again. And today, right now, I am putting spots on my map on several small communities that I find to be spot on. And I'd like you to join me as we learn a little bit about some of these communities. In fact, I have one in mind for today that you might rather enjoy. So please join me as we explore this community together.
Truman lies 20 miles to the north of the Iowa border in south-central Minnesota. Founded when railroad came through the area in 1899, their city features an independent school district, exceptional quality of life, and a safe atmosphere to raise a family. Take part in Truman Days, the last part of July, for lots of fun and socializing with friends and relatives. I think you'll agree that Truman is a truly great place to call home.
Now, didn't I tell you that was one fabulous community? Now, let's take a look at some of their businesses.
What a great town.
Oh, yes, it was.
Yes, fantastic.
Now, Chad, have you seen our reporter Clarice's reports? She does these reports called Hid Away But Not Forgotten.
I'd love
to. Would you like to see one?
I would love to, yeah.
Hello, Sweet Swine County. This is your roving reporter, Clarice. Today, we're hidden away in Sibley County, in the town of Le Sueur. Carson Nesbitt Cosgrove originally built Cosgrove House Bed and Breakfast in 1893. CN is known as the founder of the Minnesota Valley Canning Company, or as most of us know it, the Green Giant Company. CN built this house for his wife Elizabeth, their two sons, and two daughters. A relative told the story that C.N., known as the Little Giant at 5'3", had the decorative brick fireplace mantle built so that he would look taller when leaning against it. After Elizabeth's death in the 1930s, the home was converted into a boarding house. Marilyn Webb and her late husband Wayne bought the house in 1997 and spent 3 years lovingly restoring it. The Green Giant room contains a gas fireplace and mementos from the Green Giant Company. The bridal suite has a large bath, and the Elizabeth room is named for CN's wife. The CN room was used by CN Cosgrove in the boarding house days when he returned to the area. A beautiful upstairs sitting area rounds out this charming historic home. Cosgrove House Bed and Breakfast was listed on the National Register of Historic Places in 1982. From outside Sweet Swine County, this is Clarice. And as my Norwegian Nana would have said, hid away hardly means forgotten. Bye.
That was great.
Wasn't it? It was. Yeah. And you were a great guest today. We want to thank you for being here. But before we go, can you share with us how we learn more about your music?
I like to play all over the region, so I would love to come up to Minnesota and play as much as possible. Mm-hmm. But I also have a website, if you're interested, to check out my new CD called Redemption Man here.
Yes.
And it's chadelliott.net. That's double L, double T on Elliott. And
cool.
You can find other CDs as well on there.
Wonderful.
As well as you can look at my artwork.
Thank you for being our guest today, Chad. And thank you, honey, for being the co-hostess. We so appreciated it.
And we want to thank the citizens of Sweet Swine County for their reports. And thank you, our viewing audience at the Cocklebur Morning Show, where we read out the big stories from throughout Sweet Swine County. Bye-bye.